How are you doing, guys? Thank you for watching, and this is Simulator Saturday. This is the first episode of a series I want to start, and I'm gonna play a simulator every Saturday, and this simulator is probably the most popular simulator right now. It's Euro Truck Simulator 2. Let's start our truck up. So I have my Logitech G27 steering wheel with shifter, H shifter, and pedals and everything. So I already picked up, not picked up, but I searched for a job or freight going from Dortmund to Groningen. So we're going to pick that up, but before we're going to do that, we're going to have a little introduction.
What the fuck?
So, let's... Now it's on the parking brake, now it's not, so let's see. Oh wait, we have to accept the job, and this might not be those are off freights that are not in the game normally, because I have a couple of mods. For example, I have the pro mods, I have some freight mods, other kind of things. So a couple of mods for this game to make it a little bit more awesome. So you won't see this freight in the normal game. Yeah, let's just go. So the frame rate might not be as great as it should be, but I really need to upgrade my PC. I'm saving for a new graphics card and a new CPU. But well, as you all know, it's not cheap. So it might take a little while until I have a new graphics card and CPU. But when I do, I probably have less problems with lag and FPS drops and stuff like that. So that would be totally awesome. Also, I want to do the Simulator Saturday series because, well, I kind of have a love-hate relationship with simulators, because this one, for example, is a really awesome simulator. It's really fun, but you also have really crappy simulators. I mean, a lot of German simulators, and I don't know, but Germans make simulators for everything. So sometimes they're just really bullshit, they don't make any sense. But you have a couple good ones, for example this Euro Truck Simulator, you have Microsoft Flight Simulator, that's a cool one. Some really like Farming Simulator. I have never played it. I've seen a couple of videos about Farming Simulator, and well, it didn't seem that fun to me, but hey, that's just my humble opinion. But I want to do a simulator every Saturday, so stay tuned for that. And well, we're just driving with our cargo now. You can see the cargo there. So just driving, relaxed. The maximum speed limit here is 100 kilometers per hour. I think I've set it to the speed limit for cars instead of for trucks, because well, trucks can't drive that fast. I think trucks can only drive like 90 kilometers per hour or something. Well, probably depends on which country you are in. Anyway, I want to go a little bit above the truck speed limit, so I'm using the car speed limit, but I'm not even close to 100 kilometers per hour, because I have this truck. I use the let's say the weakest engine for this truck, Because it gives you a lot more opportunity to manually shift to... well, it's more difficult that way, and... Well, I like it to be a little bit more difficult, because otherwise the game can be a little bit boring. So, yeah, that's why I have a weaker engine. Also, this is a Volvo FH... Oh, it's been a while since I played this game. Let me look up how my car's, my truck is called. Volvo FH Globetrotter XL. Yeah, it's the FH 420, whatever, blah, blah, blah. Let's see. I don't know. 428 horsepower, blah, 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 all kind of stuff. I don't really know. But anyway, it's the newest Volvo FH truck that's in the game. Well, I usually knew all the types and models of all those trucks, but it's really been a while since I played this game. So... I might not drive perfectly as well, because, like I said, it's been a while since I played this game. But... it should be alright, should be alright. As you can see, there's no speed limit here right now, because, well, this is Germany, and in Germany you drive on the Autobahn, so most of the time you can just drive as fast as you want. With trucks, that is not really the case, but like I said, I've put the speed limit to cars, so who's going to notice? I'm going 95 kilometers per hour here, and I usually don't want to go faster than 100, but probably won't really matter if the road is straight. I can go a little bit faster, not a problem at all. About 110 kilometers per hour is accepted for a truck, I think. Let's see, we have enough fuel, so we don't have to get more. I don't think we have to sleep. Or do we have to sleep? I don't remember if the bar on the... on the GPS, if the sleep icon is up, does that mean that you have to sleep or that you don't have to sleep at all? Well, for safety, let's just find the next rest stop and sleep there. I don't know when it will be, so it might take a while. Oops, rumble stripes. Alrighty. Let's check if... someone is coming. Nope. Well, now there is, but I was here first, you bastard. Oh, I should have looked. I'm sorry, that was my bad. I should have looked to the right. Yeah, I'm not a great driver by any means. I mean, in real life I don't even have a driver's license, so you would probably be able to notice while watching this video, but I'm trying my best, I'm trying my best. Like I said, I have to get the hang of it again, so maybe later in this video I will be a little bit better. So here I have to downshift because we're going up, and if you have a more powerful engine, you don't have to do it. So this adds makes it more difficult. You have to do more. So I really like it to have a weaker engine. Oh yes, did you hear me yawning? That means it's time to go to sleep. So I have to find a place where I can sleep. Let's look at the minimap. Alright, there's gonna be a gas station in a while. Let's hope we can make it. Let's close that minimap for now, because there's also a minimap in our dashboard, which I like way more. Also, if you have a weaker engine, it's more difficult to overtake people. I shouldn't have. See? Yeah, I totally did fuck that up. Alright, now I can do it. I can see pretty far ahead, so nobody is coming. I'm able to overtake him. I have to wait a bit until I have enough clearance between my trailer and the truck behind me, but that's good right now, so... Yeah, I fucked that overtaking up pretty badly, but... I didn't crash into anyone, so... That's one thing I did right. Alright. I want to overtake him as well. But I can't see anything past this corner, so... Oh no, I don't have to overtake him, because... There's the gas station coming up very soon. Alright. So, at first I didn't know how to get into this gas station. But I think I do, because... On the sign there, it says you can't go left here. So I guess I can't go just go in there and drive in there. This was over a sign. I think I have to turn around right here. I have to use my mirrors. Be very careful, because I do have a long trailer behind me. Well, not that long, but long enough. Alright, first let's look if we have to fuel. Oh, wrong button. Excuse me. We do have to fuel a little bit, and then we're going to get some sleep. Sleeping is important, don't you think? If you don't sleep, you'll die. Very careful that my trailer doesn't hit the gas pump. Alright, here we'll be okay, I think. Come on. Alrighty then. Parking brake on, turn the engine off, and let's sleep! You are getting some rest! Alright, so right now I'm getting some rest. Oh, I had some rest, and now I'm awake again. First thing I have to do is turn my lights on. Because otherwise people will go really mad at me. And let's see, I want my auxiliary illumination on. Not Illuminati, but illumination. I see you have some nice lights here. Looking really nice, don't you think? So there's some high beam and there's not. And some kind of farming simulator tool, so... Yeah, let's just go ahead and drive this thing. And it's so dark, so I don't see shit, so I have to use my high beam. Nothing, no one coming. No one coming there as well. At least I think that's the way I do it. You have to turn around to get to this gas station. But if that's not the case and you know how it should be done, if you know the rules, then please tell me. I would totally appreciate it. Because, well, I'm a noob about rules on the road and stuff like that. Also, I don't know if I have to use my big lights here right now. I really don't know at all. I probably should read some trucker rules, but... Ah well. It might be a simulator, but... We don't have to follow every rule. Well, we do have to play it a little bit better than how we play games like Grand Theft Auto. Have to watch the speed limit here, can only go 80. I like to put the dashboard thing to show digital numbers for the speed, because then you have a more accurate view of your speed. I can't go above 80 here, and that sucks, but it's dark, so probably a wise idea to take it slow a little bit. It's dark and there are some curves here. Right here's a curve, so why not take it slow, just to be on the safe side. This is small roads, pretty small. I believe we are going to Rotterdam, but let's check. Groningen, we're going to Groningen. So Groningen is in Holland, and that's where I come from, so that's awesome. Well, I don't come from Groningen. Groningen is just a city in Holland, but... Well, it's the same country, so... That's good enough for me. Give a little bit more speed, a little bit more gas, because we're going really slow. But I do not know if we're already in Holland. I didn't see any signs like, welcome to Holland, or anything like that. But those biking lanes on the side of the road, they seem really Dutch to me, but I could be mistaken. Might also be really German, I don't know. I haven't been to Germany that often, so I don't really know. And I've never driven on German roads, because like I said, I don't have a driver's license, I don't have a car, so no. I mean, I've sit in the backseat of my parents when we went to Germany for... I don't even know if I've been to Germany with my parents. I did go with my ex-girlfriend once and her parents, and probably went with my parents just passing through Germany to go to like Spain or France or something, but I don't really know actually if I've been on vacation there or something. But yeah, might try it one time. I've heard good things about Germany, so, and it's pretty close to me, so why not? And I really don't like that I have to go so slow, because I have to keep my foot on the gas pedal like really steadily. Can't push it too hard or too little, because otherwise I'll slow down or I go too fast. I don't like that. I mean, I can go exactly 80 kilometers per hour and then just put on cruise control like how I do now, and then I just can lift my foot up. But then when you get in the corner, you don't have as much how do you call it, as much control, because you're in cruise control. So I'd rather do it manually, because in corners I like to go a little bit slower when you go into the corner, and then give some extra gas when you're inside the corner, because you will get some more grip. At least in this game, that's how it works. I don't know how it works in real life. Oh, what's going on here? Oh no. Oh, how long do I have to wait? Oh, not that long at all. I have to be careful here. It's a little bit narrower than usually on the roads. Ah, it was only a little part. Alright. See if someone's coming. No. Again, with the biking lanes on the side. Yeah, I'm really wondering if I'm already inside Holland or not. Ah, my steering wheel is acting up a little bit. Sometimes I use a plug-in. I think it's called realistic feedback or something. But sometimes it just disables, and then my steering goes really weird. It doesn't really work with me. So really weird. So I think the plugin disabled just now, and that sucks really badly, because I'm really used to the force feedback mod, and driving without it is really weird. So I have to look up why that keeps happening to me. Well, see, if I have to quickly turn, it's so much feedback going on, right? So sturdy. It's really difficult to turn, but we're almost there anyway, so it doesn't really matter that much. So we have to park there. I'm really bad at parking, so, oh, and especially now that the force feedback mod is disabled. Alright. I mean, going to the front a lot, but doesn't matter, just do it the way it's easy for you. Do you hear all those cows? Fucking weird, man. This is, well, I am delivering some farming tools, so, well, I guess it's normal that it's on a farm and damn, I'm really fucking up right now. Come on. Come on, is it good enough? Almost. Damn. Alright, so the game thinks it's good enough, so I agree with the game then. And I've done it, I've delivered a Krone Big M500 from Dortmund to Groningen. I've got some money, got some experience, and I haven't had any crashes or problems whatsoever, so basically I'm amazing. So guys, thank you very much for watching the first episode of Simulator Saturday. I hope you enjoyed it, and if you liked it, like the video, subscribe to my channel, leave a comment if you have something to say. I would totally appreciate it. I like to keep in touch with you guys because you're the reason that I'm doing this. So awesome guys, just want to say catch you on the flip side. Cheers.